those days. Oh yeah, we had Frank Sinatra in those days. He was just omnipresent and did all the great songs. He was very endearing to musicians, especially because he came up in the ranks, riding on the band bus, working hard, the one-nighters, wearing the tuxes with his brown shoes. You know, he was just one of the guys, and he did all the great songs, really applied himself and really focused on his craft and his breathing, especially, which he said he learned the art of breathing from his boss, the band leader Tommy Dorsey, who was a trombone player who was known for his expertise in his breath control playing trombone. Anyway, I could go on and on talking about Frank, but I'm just gonna do a bunch of his songs, and they're just some of my favorite. Where did I do it? What did I do with the list? Well, if I need it, I'll take a short break and get it. Right now, I don't need it. So, this first one is from his album called "Songs for Swingin' Lovers," which was one of his best, I think. I took a trip on a train, and I thought about you. Down a shadowy lane, and I thought about you. Two or three cars parked under the stars, winding stream. Moon shining down on some little town, and with each beam, the same old dream. Every stop that we made, oh, I thought about you. When I pulled down the shade, then I really felt blue. I peeked through the crack and looked at that track, one going back to you. And what did I do? I thought about you. Took a trip on a train, and I thought about you. Looked down a shadowy lane, and I really felt blue. Two or three cars parked under the stars, winding stream. Moon shining down on some little town, with each beam the same. Stop that we made, oh, I thought about you. When I pulled down the shade, then I really felt blue. I peeked through the crack and looked at that track, the one going back to you. What did I do? What did I do? What did I do? Written by Jimmy Van Heusen, one of Frank's buddies he used to pal around with out in California. And I know this isn't really a Frank Sinatra hat, and it looks kind of silly, so I'm going to take it off, if you don't mind. It's just kind of a silly-looking hat, right? So, yeah. Oh. this was a little joke we were going to play, but this is the bishop's hat, but... one of his buddies saw a picture of me in this on the internet, and he says, "Oh, he's not supposed to be wearing that, is he? Really? It's not ecclesiastical, or it's not legal, or whatever." Anyway. It didn't work. It got stuck in there. Okay.
Pink socks.
This is one of the first Sinatra songs I remember because it was kind of a kid's song in a way. And Bing Crosby originally did it, but Frank's version, I think, is probably better. Right? Better off than you are. You can find yourself swinging on a star. Would you like to swing on a star and be better off than you are? And be better off than you are. You could be swinging on a star. A mule is an animal with long, funny ears. He kicks up at everything he hears. Brain is weak. He's just plain stupid with a stubborn streak. And by the way, if you hate to go to school, you might grow up to be a mule. Or would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a pig? A pig is an animal with dirt on his face. His shoes are a terrible disgrace. He's got no manners when he eats his food. He's fat and lazy and extremely rude. But if you don't care a feather or a fig, you might grow up to be a pig. How would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? You could be swinging on a star. A fish is an animal that swims in a brook. He can't write his name or read a book. To fool the people is his only thought. And though he's slippery, he still gets caught. But then if that sort of life is what you wish, you might grow up to be a fish. And all the monkeys are in a zoo. Every day you meet quite a few. So you can see it's all up to you. You could be swinging on a star. I think that was also written by Jimmy Van Heusen, but it wasn't Van Heusen. It was some unpronounceable name, but anyway. This one I was going to do as an instrumental, but it's got such nice words, I think I'm going to attempt to sing it. It's a nice ballad, beautiful ballad that is also from the Songs for Swinging Lovers album, I believe, and it's called We'll Be Together Again. Tears, no fears. Remember, there's always tomorrow. So what if we have to part? We'll be together again. Your kiss, your smile, memories I'll treasure forever. So try thinking with your heart, we'll be together again. Times when I know you'll be lonesome, times when I know you'll be sad. Don't let temptation surround you, don't let the blues make you bad. Someday, some way, we both have a lifetime before us. For parting is not goodbye, we'll be together again. Surround you, don't let the blues make you bad. Someday, some way, we both have a lifetime before us. For parting is not goodbye, we'll be together again. Thank you. That's on a CD. It's available in the back. It's called Souvenir from Paris with Love is the English title. So it's an album CD I recorded in Paris, and that song is on there. that reminds me of another song that I've heard Frank do, but after I do this one, I'll do one more, and then maybe we can talk Serge into coming up and telling a Frank Sinatra story. Anyway, this is as close as I'm going to come tonight to singing a song in French. Ooh la la la. Okay, that's it. And by the way, you're welcome to mingle in and out. There's some food in the back, and is that right?
Yeah.
If it's okay with the bishop, then it's okay with me. So. When love comes in and takes you for a spin, ooh la la la, everybody say magnifica. When every night your loved one holds you tight, ooh la la la, say magnifica. But when one day your loved one drifts away, ooh la la la, it is so tragica. But when once more she whispers je t'adore, say magnifique. I'd like to introduce my friend Serge, who actually used to talk to, well, I'll let you tell, he'll tell you the story. I'm not even going to say it, but he has a little story about Frank Sinatra.
Can you hear me?
Oh.
I was very fortunate as a young man. My mother and aunt were performers, stage performers and singers, and surrounded by wonderful people. And as a young person, one day, most of you people are probably too young to remember this, but we used to have phones that had dials and handles and things. Remember that? Yeah. And so the phone rang once at the house, and I happened to be near it. And being the young person that I was, always liked to getting involved, I picked up the phone and said, yeah. And a person said, is your mother there? And I sort of said, yeah, who's calling? He said, this is Frank Sinatra. I went pale. As I was standing with this, the phone in my hand, I looked at my mother and she was coming over. Why was I talking on the phone? I said, it's Frank Sinatra. And she said, go away. And she got on the phone. Of course, I didn't go too far. I had to hear what the conversation was. And she said, Francis, I can't thank you enough. Really, thank you so much. And hung up the phone. And I'm saying, okay. The next day, a knock at the door. A gentleman dressed to the nines. In those days, that's all I ever remember. Guys coming in, white on white shirts and hats that match their suits. And they knocked on the door. And I opened it, of course, being the doorman. And I said, yeah, this guy was dressed to the nines. And he said, is your mother here? I said, yeah, hold on. And I went and said, Ma, there's somebody at the door. And she went and he said, Mr. Sinatra asked me to give you this envelope. I didn't know, I guess, we couldn't pay the rent. And, you know, in those days when you weren't working on the stage, you weren't getting paid. So, and I bring that up only because there's so many stories like that that Francis Albert did for people. And a lot of that was never released in the papers. It was just a quiet thing. I mean, he was a caregiver, an unbelievable human being helping people out that needed it when they needed that. And that was one of the, that is probably the only story I'll share with you tonight, other than the fact that the man saved my life 1,000 times. Over and over again, just listening to his music and understanding the lyrics and what they meant. And that was probably one of the best gifts that was ever given to a young kid in New York, is understanding lyrics and what they meant. That's about it, Steve. I can't go much more other than that. You know, the rest I'm not allowed to talk about.
sometimes when I'm playing in a nightclub or a piano bar, I'll get requests, can you play a Frank Sinatra song? And I go, you're just, all of a sudden, your mind is overwhelmed because he has so many different periods and so many different styles and so many different types of songs that he did. And you could, so sometimes I'll start playing a song and I'll go, no, not that kind of Frank Sinatra. You know, so you have to be careful. You kind of have to be able to read minds sometimes a little bit. But of course, Frank Sinatra did a lot of songs from the, almost all his songs were from the what's called the Great American Songbook. Now, this is not a book you can go down to the music store and buy the volume. It's a concept of the American song composers from the 30s and 40s, and then it goes spreads out from there a little bit. There were five great composers: Gershwin, Cole Porter, Irving Berlin. There's about 12 great composers. You could go on and on. Harold Arlen, Richard Rodgers. But anyway, I'm going to do another. That last one I did actually was Cole Porter, Say Magnifique. And I'm going to do another Cole Porter song because I think Frank Sinatra especially liked Cole Porter. He especially liked any great composer. But this is one where he happened to sing the verse to it. I believe he sang the verse to this, but if he didn't, I'm going to, so I'll have to answer to Frank later if I hear that. As Dorothy Parker once said to her boyfriend, fare thee well. As Columbus announced before he was bounced, it was swell, Isabel, swell. As Abelard said to Eloise, don't forget to drop a line to me, please. As Juliet cried into Romeo's ear, Romeo, why not face the facts, my dear? It was just one of those things, just one of those crazy flings, one of those bells that now and then rings. It was just one of those things. It was just one of those nights, just one of those fabulous flights, a trip to the moon on gossamer wings. It was just one of those things. If we thought a bit of the end of it before we'd started painting the town, we'd have been aware that this love affair was too hot not to go down. So goodbye, dear, and amen. Here's hoping we meet now and then. It was great fun, but it was just one of those things. If we thought a bit of the end of it before we'd started painting the town, we'd have been aware that this love affair was too hot not to cool down. So goodbye, dear, and amen. Here's hoping we meet now and then. Was great fun, but it was just one of those things.
Thank you.
Well, I have a little tiny Frank Sinatra story to tell. I never saw him perform in person because whenever he was around performing, I was usually playing a gig or whatever. But one night in Chicago after the gig, I went over to the Pump Room and on State Street, and some friends of mine were performing there. And I walked in, and the bartender knew me. He said, "Hey," and I sat down and said hi to my musician friends who were performing. Just a couple of minutes after that, this group of 10 or 12 guys comes walking in, and there's Frank Sinatra walking into the Pump Room, and he sat at a big table kind of in the middle of the room, and there were three guys standing around the table kind of like this so that nobody dared approach the table. And my friends in the band said, "Oh, I guess we've been asked to play later because we were supposed to quit now, in a couple of minutes." So I said, "Well, that's good. Sorry I can't talk to you, but I'll like to listen to the music too." So I sat there and listened to the music, and there's Frank over there chatting with his friends and listening to the music. And so I got to spend a little moment after my gig, and he was in there after his gig, and we were just kind of hanging out together or whatever. Yeah, me and Frank, like that. Yeah. No. On my list, I noticed that about a third of them are Cole Porter songs, so I'm going to try to do a different one. let's see. Oh, here, he did a couple of pop songs that weren't really, when he did them, they were on a different level, of course, but this is one of my favorite ones, a little bluesy from the 60s. Oh, that's life. That's what people say. Riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change my tune when I'm back on top in June. That's life. Funny as it seems, some people get their kick stepping on dreams. But I won't let it get me down, 'cause this old world keeps on spinning round. Been up and down and over round. I know one thing, that each time I find myself flat on my face, I'm gonna pick myself up, get back in the race. That's life. I can't deny it. I've thought of quitting, but my heart won't buy it. I didn't think it was worth a try. Why, I would wrap myself up in a great big ball and die. I've been up and down and over round. I know one thing, that each time I find myself flat on my face, I'm gonna pick myself up, get back in the race. That's life. I can't deny it. I've thought of quitting, but my heart won't buy it. I didn't think it was worth a try. And I would wrap myself up in a great big ball and die. Yeah. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars, and let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, in other words, in other words, I love you. Yeah, that was one of his big ones. He used to call it, in other words, it's called Fly Me to the Moon. Yeah. He did a couple of songs to cities, but of course I got to do the one about my hometown. Chicago, Chicago. That title in town. Chicago, Chicago, come on, I will show you around. It's your bottom dollar that you lose the blues in Chicago. Chicago, it's the town that Billy Sunday could not shut down. There's State Street, that great street, and I just want to say, they do things they just don't do on Broadway or in L.A. You'll have the time of your life. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago, Chicago, my hometown. Thank you. Chicago, Chicago, that title and town. Chicago, Chicago, come on, I'll show you around. I bet your bottom dollar that you'll lose the blues in Chicago, Chicago, the town where Billy's Sunday could not shut down. There's State Street, that great street, and I just want to say, they do things they just don't do on Broadway. Say, you'll have the time of your life. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago, in Chicago, Chicago, that's my hometown. Is it an earthquake or simply the shock? Is it the good turtle soup or merely the mock? Is it a cocktail, this feeling of joy? Or is what I feel the real McCoy? Is it for all time or simply a lark? Is it Granada I see, or only Asbury Park? Is it a fancy not worth thinking of? Or is it at long last love? Simply the shack. Is it the good turtle soup or merely the mac? Is it a cocktail, this feeling of joy? Or is what I feel the real McCoy? Is it for all time or simply a lark? Is it Granada I see, or only Asbury Park? Is it a fancy not worth thinking of? Or is it at long last love? It's another Cole Porter song. A lot of jazz musicians were inspired, the instrumentalists, and some of the, for instance, Miles Davis did several instrumentals after Frank Sinatra did them, and did a very good version of them, and you can see the connection there that, oh, Miles Davis, he was listening to Frank Sinatra, so he did instrumental versions of some of his vocal songs. So I'm going to do one instrumental, and this is one that I, you know, did when I was first starting out as an instrumental. It's from the musical Finnegan's Rainbow by Burton Lane. It's called Old Devil Moon. Thank you. That Old Devil Moon. What a great audience. Thank you. Thanks all for coming tonight on this rainy night. We have more people than I thought we might on a night like this. Have we got time for a couple more songs? Okay. I'm just thinking, I realized Frank Sinatra did probably more percentage of ballads and love songs than I'm doing tonight. For some reason, I'm doing more of the up-tempo songs. I don't know why, but I'm going to do one of his ballads that I just love. And he actually had an album with the title of this song. And it's in the wee small hours of the morning. Asleep, you lie awake and you think about the girl and never ever think of counting sheep. When your lonely heart has learned its lesson, she'd be yours if only she would call. In the wee small hours of the morning, that's the time you'll miss her most of all. When the sun sits high in the afternoon sky, you can always find something to do. But from dusk till dawn, the clock ticks on. Something happens to you. When your lonely heart has learned its lesson, she'd be yours if only she would call. In the wee small hours of the morning, that's the time you'll miss her most of all. Oh, we have an announcement.
Yeah, one more. We have to do the. Somebody, I remember a fellow that came in from New York who had a restaurant here in town. It was an Italian restaurant. He's really great. Great chef, great place, but he didn't like Sedona. He called it Slowdona. And I guess it was true because that was about 20 years ago, and everybody, you know, when the sun went down, we all went home.
Oh. Well.
Anyway, thanks for coming. It's here in Sedona, you have to look around for spots that have jazz. And isn't it cool that God's house has jazz in it? It's just unbelievable, you know. Yeah. And we have more musicians. We've got a guitar player, and we have a vocalist, and it's just so groovy to come in and sit down and have a good time. We've got some stuff back in the back. I don't think there's any wine anymore, but we've had a good time. Thanks for coming. We're doing something on Christmas Eve, Steve and Susanna Martin, and some old guy that might play flugelhorn, but I'm not sure who that is, before the Christmas Mass and during it and afterwards, too. So God bless you. Thanks for coming.
Thanks to Bishop McManus, David McManus.
I think he's going to sing a song about monkeys and going to Chicago.
I have a request that I didn't do yet from somebody on the internet. Anyway, these CDs that are on the left on the counter back there are instrumental CDs that I produced with some of the best musicians in Chicago, and they didn't cost me anything, so first come, first serve, if you want to take one of the the Royal Chicagoan CDs are free, so. And the ones on the right that are mine, you can have one for $10. Special deal. So, this request came in on the internet before I left my house, so I said I would do it. And, it's appropriate because it's the ending song, and it's about the things the best is yet to come. Out of the tree of life, I've just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? You think you've seen the sun, you ain't never seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, babe. Won't it be fine? The best is yet to come. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine, I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine, we're gonna drink the cup dry. Wait till your charms are right for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but honey, you ain't even never left the ground. Wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, babe. Wanna be fine. The best is yet to come. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. The monkey. The buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzer tried to throw the monkey off his back. He grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Everybody, straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Don't you blow your top. What's the use of jiving? Ain't no use in diving. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." So said, "Hey, monkey, you are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free." The monkey looked the buzzer right dead in the eye. He said, "Your story's so very touching, but it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right, everybody. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." One more time.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Fly right. Serge, go ahead.
There's something I want to let you know, too, a little tidbit. That song that you just did prior to this one.
Yes.
The Best Is Yet to Come, right?
Yeah.
That's on Francis Albert's tombstone.
Oh, is that
buried
right?
In Palm Springs. And that's
oh,
what's
wow.
On the
I did not know. I think you might have told me that before.
Yeah.
I forgot.
Francis Albert.
Yeah. Thank you all. I could go on all night, but we have to stop sometime. Yep, next time. Thank you all for coming. Thank you all on the internet, if you stuck in this long and watched us on the internet. Thank you. Hello.